Greetings. That was just a little snatch of music played on a Hona Marine band, equipped with one of my new Diatonic power combs, and it's also half valved with my new stealth valves. That's a B flat and power bender tuning, by the way. So I started designing and making custom 3D printed chromatic harmonica combs about 2 or 3 years ago, and they've been very well received by chromatic players. And I did think about making Diatonic combs, but there's so many great custom combs out there on the market already that it just seemed kind of a little bit redundant to be, you know, putting out yet more, you know, sort of sandwich type combs that were the same as everything else. Of course, there's one difference is that my new combs are 3D printed. They'll be the first commercially available 3D printed Diatonic harmonica combs in the world, as far as I know. But that's not really enough of a reason to put them out there. I mean, there's good advantages of 3D printing. They come in a, you know, huge range of colours. You can actually colour code your entire harmonica collection. 12 keys, 12 colours, and we've got some extra ones as well. So that's, you know, it's a nice little feature of 3D printed combs, but it's still not enough to really put them out there. Probably the main reason that I decided to get them out was to make a comb that was valve friendly. I mean, I came up with the idea of half valving in about 1980, and I've been half valving my harmonicas ever since. But I've had to take existing combs and manually carve out pockets at the back of the chambers in order to take the valves, because most commercial combs don't have enough room for valves, and nor do existing custom combs around either. So all my combs are valve friendly. They've got valve pockets on the underside, so you can actually full valve them, or they suit half valving as well. Like in Richter tuning, you'd only have valves on the bottom six holes. But anyway, they can take valves everywhere you want. Another thing is that because I play a lot of different tunings and a lot of different size harps, from the Lucky 13 to you know, the big Hona 10, 12 and 14 hole harps, my notes are in different places on all the on all the harps I use. So I decided to take an idea from guitars and put a little location marker on the comb. I call it the look dot. So on my 10-hole combs, there's a little dot right in the middle there. It's actually between holes number 5 and 6. And on the bigger combs, there's a couple of dots, or even 3 or 4 dots. You can instantly get a visual location point of where the notes are. You don't have to look on the numbers, and, you know, in dark light, sometimes it's hard to see the numbers. But this little look dot really gives you a very fast way to check out where you are on the harp. So on my on the Diatonic combs, it's between holes 5 and 6. So on a Richter tuned harp, hole 6 would be your tonic note in second position. On my power benders, it's still my tonic note, but I know it's a draw note, so I can just go there. I find it just so handy, particularly on the Lucky 13, which is the harmonica that I've developed and I'm using in many of the harps in my gig box, are Lucky 13s. The look dot really just helps you find your way around on this bigger harp. So again, that little dot there is between holes 5 and 6 in the normal range. So I know where, you know, where my hole 6 is just by looking at that dot. And then the lower dot down here marks the dividing point between the normal low octave and the extra low octave. Okay, so basically it makes the Lucky 13 kind of easier and more user friendly than with just a complete black comb. And of course, these combs come in about 15 different colors. The look dot's also really useful on the big Hona harps, 14-hole Honas. Again, these come in all sorts of colours and everything, but the main thing is that you've got the look dots on the front. and it really helps just orient yourself on these massive big 14-hole beasts. You know, like if I want to play, I just know exactly where my hole 4 and hole 6, hole 7, everything are just by looking at the look dots. And it really helps me with, you know, different tunings. So this is a D SBS, which I've retuned to double Paddy Richter. So you can hear the that was a Paddy Richter in the normal low octave, and then I can go down lower. And that's the sound of my stealth valves in there. They're called stealth valves because they basically make no discernible sound. They work really reliably. Once you've got them in there, basically you forget they're inside. That's the whole concept. And I've come up with a very, very simple way of installing the stealth valves, and I've made a couple of videos for that. Likewise, on the 12-hole Hohner models, these come in a couple of different tunings, kind of Richter and also solo. This one's in solo tuning, and I've fully valved it, just as you would with a chromatic, on the inside and the outside. Another feature of my combs is that they have slotted screw holes, and that means that you can actually adjust the reed plates a little bit back and forward depending on your preferred you know, front mouth feel. Some people like the reed plates slightly ahead of the comb. That's often how they come from the manufacturers. Personally, I like the reed plates back and flush with the front of the comb, but the slotted screw holes allow you to adjust the reed plates according to your personal preference. Another little feature, a nice little feature that I can offer with the 3D printing is a personalised name option. So if you want to have your name on the side of the harp, you just have to you know, put it in when you make the order, and we can add the name for a small extra charge. Now you'll notice on most of my combs there's a little strut running along horizontally. This is basically just for extra stability of the tines. But it's very easy to remove. If you want to get rid of it, you just put the comb down and cut through the strut, and it's gone. So you can have it or not, as you like. And personally, I really like the fun aspect of all the different colours. This yellow one's a sort of an F-sharp, Hohner Thunderbird and F-sharp. This white one is it's a Suzuki Mungie in F. These are all in power bender tuning, by the way. This red one is it's kind of Hohner crossover plates on one of my combs, and again, power bender tuning, half valved. And this black one here is B flat. So one thing to be aware of with my combs is that the back of the comb is going to vary a little bit from comb to comb. The finish of it, maybe it might have some tiny little inclusions or whatever. We try and minimize those, but how they come off the printer is really a little bit unpredictable. But in all the important areas, like the flat sanding of the reed plate surfaces and the smooth finish and rounded tines of the front, you'll find these combs give you a really lovely feel in the mouth and really good air seal between the reed plates and the comb.